What's going on, beautiful people? Welcome to We Teach AI Designs. And in this video, we're going to show you how to upload an image to turn this into this. Let's get right into it. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is we want to find our image. It could be an image of yourself. It could be an image of a friend, or it could be an image that you find on a royalty-free site. Currently, right now, I am on pixels.com. These are all royalty-free images that, you know, we can use to be able to create content for whatever we need it for. Now, if you are uploading images of your friend or someone else, make sure you get their permission before you do so. All right, so this is the image that I'm going to go with. I've already downloaded it. So we're going to jump right over here into Discord, and we're going to click the bottom left-hand corner where we would typically put our messages in, or rather our prompts. I'm going to click that. Click. Upload a file. So we're going to find our image, and we have clicked. We've uploaded it here, and we want to click enter. We want it to actually go inside of our feed. We want to go ahead and click it. Click open original. And what this is going to do is it's going to allow us to be able to copy the actual URL from a different tab. So we're going to copy that. And the first thing I'm going to do is inside my online notes tab, where I have my prompt of what I want it to look like, I'm going to go ahead and paste this right here at the top. So I have online notes tab. This is memo on notepad.com. It's free to use. It's an online notepad. You can use any type of notes application that you got. I just like to keep things on my freaking, you know, tabs right here, so I could just go tap, tap, tap. All right, so perfect. So right below it, I have the description that I want to have, and I'll link this at the end of the video as well. So black woman, medium shot, high angle, Jamaican carnival, real facial features, bright colors, no painting, photography, cinematic, lighting, Unreal Engine, hyper realistic, hyper detailed. I am going to add one more prompt, and I am going to, let's say we want it to be 8K. That gives me a pretty good image. So we're going to copy all of what we have here, including the URL from the image. Perfect. Now we're going to click our message, just like we, you know, excuse me, our imagine prompt, just like we would do any other image. Click enter, and we're going to paste. I'm going to paste all the information that we just inputted. I'm going to paste all that information that we just inputted. So it's something I want you guys to remember, that this isn't Lensa. This isn't a Snapchat filter. This isn't the filter swap face apps that's on your phone. This is simply to get inspiration from an image. You can get it pretty close to the actual image that you upload, whether it's a selfie or, you know, a picture of your friend or a royalty-free image. But this is to get some of the facial features that you want in an image to be more like the image that you've actually selected. So just understand that, you know, you may have to re-roll it a couple times. You may have to create different variations. And I have videos to show you guys how to do those things. But just understand, I don't want you to get upset if it doesn't look exactly how your face, or exactly like the image the first time you do it. So let's check our prompts here. All right, perfect. So let's take a look here. This is what it looks like before, and this is what it looks like after. So you can see the facial features are very similar to what we have in our original image. Now, understand that this is just simply taking the inspiration, the facial structure, the lips, it's a more of an inspiration tool than it's a direct filter. So let's kind of see what we want specifically it to be. Let's say it's the top left hand corner. Okay, perfect. So we did that, and we want to go ahead and upscale the top left hand corner. But let's say we want to get a variation of the top right hand corner, because that looks pretty pretty accurate as well. So we want to put V2 for variation. As a matter of fact, let's upscale it first, but let's go ahead and get a variation too, because I think that was pretty good. We're going to click submit. We're not going to change anything. Okay, dope. So we finished processing, and these are the outputs that we got here. Let's start with the original image here. This is the original inspiration image, the source image. This is the two that we upscaled. Bam. Bam. So I think these two probably look most closely associated with each other. But yeah, I like them as inspiration. I love them as to be able to create something just that much more original, and being able to use a free website without having to worry about any copyright issues. I'm gonna put those the website in the description below, but it's pexels.com. There's a bunch more free websites that I could also link for you in the bio, so make sure you check in the description, so that way you guys have access to as much as possible. You can click man, woman, portrait, business person, and it's going to be able to give you some really good dope stuff. So, and I'm also going to put my prompt that I used to create the image in there as well. All right, so that was how you upload an image. Overstand that this isn't necessarily a Lensa app. It's not a filter. This is something that you're going to be using for inspiration. So if you want to upload your own image, you could be like, hey, this is not exactly looking how I want it to look. You can always create variations. You can also re-roll all four images, so that way it gives you a prompt of something that is more closely associated to what you want. Continue trying it out, you know. You're definitely going to get something that's close to what you want. Just don't feel no type of way if it's not exactly what you're looking for, the way some of these apps that do like the face swaps do. This is something that's entirely different stuff for inspiration and all that good stuff. So if you found this video helpful, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff, and just let me know what video you want me to do next, and stay to the end of the video, so that way I could provide you all the prompts, so that way you could take it and be able to manipulate some of the prompts that I use for your stuff. Yeah. Till next time, y'all.